The first thing we find that conception takes place. And even Jesus himself, that first moment when he stepped onto the earth, conception took place through a virgin named Mary. God the Father, who is able to create all things, divinely impregnated Mary through the Holy Spirit, allowing Jesus to be born. And you may wonder why. Why did it have to be this way? It's because we know that all of us have the Adamic nature. The Adamic nature is a sinful nature. That is why you find sometimes some people have spoken about this, where they're playing with a child, and next thing they in their mind they have thoughts of just throwing the child away or bad thoughts towards the child. But deep down they don't feel this way. But negative thoughts are put in their mind about a certain thing. Or if they have like an argument with somebody, something inside of them says, just, you know, why don't you just take a knife or kill this person or murder this person? That's stemming from the Adamic nature, the sinful nature within us. And every one of us born down the line of the first Adam are born with the sinful nature. But Jesus could not be born with the sinful nature. If he was born with the sinful nature, he could not die on the cross. Therefore, I tell you, everything in Jesus' life is not insignificant. There is significance in everything Jesus does. And God divinely did. Right to the finest detail. And therefore, you find Jesus was conceived of the Father divinely. So Jesus did not have the Adamic nature, the sinful nature in him. Even to the time when he went to the cross and beyond, he was sinless. The only time that Jesus had sin on him was when he bore our sins as the Lamb. And if you know how the sin offering is done in the natural, then you will understand what happened on the cross, how our sins were transferred onto Jesus. Likewise, when the people of old used to bring the sin offering, the sins used to be transferred onto the sin offering. Likewise, our sinful state was transferred, and sinful sins was transferred onto Jesus on that cross, for he died in our place. You find God will put an idea and a word in you. Like he did with Abraham, he said, you'll be the father of many nations. Like he did with Noah. He told Noah, build an ark. You think Noah must have found it easy to continue building that ark day in and day out while people mocked him? Every day, every part of the day, different people came and mocked him and said, where's the rain you were talking about? What you building this huge thing for? You think it must have been easy? So when God, you come to God, you are impregnated with Jesus in your life, or with a word from God, don't be surprised when daily you are mocked. Daily you are questioned. You find even the Pharisees questioned Jesus and took every opportunity to question him, so to trap him, so that the people will see that Jesus is not so good as they seem. They wanted to prove Jesus wrong. If they did it to Jesus, you think they won't do it to you? So Noah must have experienced, while he was pregnant with his ark, the vision that God gave him, how to build the ark, the method, the wood to use. But he continued. You find that the trimester we learn about the conception It says here, you meet God in a new way. How do we understand this? You know, Nicodemus, I'm reminded about John 3 verse 4, where Nicodemus didn't understand. He actually thought that we need to re-enter our mother's womb to be reborn. But being reborn in the realm of the spirit means you are being spiritually born, born again. That you're no longer of the old nature, the Adamic nature, but you take on the form of Jesus in your life. You are spiritually changed. You no longer walk after the flesh, but you walk after the spirit. GospelLoops.com.